Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be walking through a clamped cubic spline interpolation example. If you missed our previous video on the theory of cubic spline interpolation, I will leave a link in the description down below for you. Before we jump into the example, let's quickly recap what cubic spline interpolation is. Cubic spline interpolation is a mathematical technique used to approximate a smooth curve passing through a given set of points. It's especially useful in situations where we have a scattered data set, and we want to create a continuous curve that captures a general trend. We can then use that curve to find valuable information about our underlying data. All right, let's take a look at our example. Here we have a set of data points representing the growth of a plant over time. Our goal is to interpolate a smooth curve that accurately represents the growth pattern between these supplied discrete data points. As you can see, we have four data points, and our task is to find the clamped cubic spline that passes through these data points. And we are also told at our endpoints that we have a derivative of 4. As we learned in our cubic spline interpolation theory video, we know that we will always have one less spline than our supplied number of data points. Therefore, with 4 data points, we will have 3 splines to fit cubic functions to. We also learn that for each spline we need to find, denoted by n, we will need to find 4n equations such that we can solve for our 4n missing coefficients. Therefore, we have 12 missing coefficients as you can see here. So, let's quickly make a plan of attack on how we want to go about solving this problem. First, we are going to find 12 equations such that we can find our 12 missing coefficients. And to find them, we will plug our 12 equations into a linear system of equation solver, and then complete the problem. But stay with me and we'll walk through this problem fully together. So, let's begin by trying to find our 12 equations. As we learned in the previous theory video, we can get 2n equations through evaluating each of our 3 polynomial functions at our known data points. So, let's just go ahead and do that. All we're doing here is simply plugging in our x values and simplifying. But to elaborate a bit more, we're going to evaluate our first polynomial with its 2 data points, so x1 and x2. p2 will be evaluated at x2 and x3, and lastly, p3 will be evaluated at x3 and x4. As you can see here, this results in 6 of our 12 equations. Secondly, again as we learned in the cubic spline interpolation theory video, we can find n-1 equations through the property of smoothness at our interior data points through equating our first derivatives, which in this example will give us 2 more equations as we have 2 interior data points. So, we simply find the derivatives of our polynomials with touching interior data points, and then evaluate them at that input. And here are the 2 equations that we get from this. Likewise, we can find n-1 equations from doing the same thing with our second derivatives. As in cubic spline interpolation, we have smoothness at both the first and second derivatives. Then we are going to equate them and plug in our x values just like we did earlier, and here it is x equals 3. This works out to the following equation, and I'm just going to rearrange it such that all variables are on one side and the constant on the other side of the equation. Secondly, we will repeat this process for our second interior data point between p2 and p3. Therefore, we will again take the derivative of our first derivative, p2 and p3 functions we found earlier, and evaluate them at x equals x3, which is 5. And again, just rearranging and putting everything to one side, and it results in this equation. Now, as you can see, we have 10 equations and are only missing 2. As we were told earlier to use clamped cubic spline and our instantaneous rate of slope at both endpoints is 4, we're going to use that now. In a clamped cubic spline, we'll use some known facts about the rate of change at the endpoints of our interpolating function. As we were told in the beginning of our question, assume that the rate of change at points x1 and x4 are 4. So let's just go ahead and use our previously calculated first derivative of p1 and p3 at points x1 and x4, respectively, to get our remaining two equations. Now that we have all of our 12 equations, we can fully solve for our 12 unknowns. To do this, we could try doing it manually, however, this would not be fun. Through using simple polynomials, we will always have linear equations, and therefore a system of linear equations. We can use our linear system of equation solvers that we have developed in the past. So, let's just write out our matrix so that we know what we are going to be trying to solve for. You can think of these columns as our coefficient values for each of our equations. And I will write this out like so it's easier to visualize. Now, I'm going to use our Gauss elimination solver with partial pivoting that we developed in a previous numerical methods video. I will leave a link to that video down in the description down below if you missed it. However, there are also a system of linear equation solvers online that you could find by Googling them. Now that we are inside Python, I have opened the Gauss elimination system of equation solver with partial pivoting. I took a minute already and entered our square matrix we just wrote down and entered it into our variable and constant matrices here. Now, we just need to call our function and insert our variable matrix and then our constant matrix and run the program. As you can see, we have now solved for all of our 12 unknowns. Each of these x values represents a coefficient for our three interpolating polynomials. x0 is a1, x1 is b1, x2 is c1, x3 is d1, and so on. To visualize these polynomials, I'm just going to plot them rather crudely inside Microsoft Excel, keeping in mind our domains that we talked about previously. As you can see, this results in the very nice smooth function. In the previous video, we were asked to interpolate over the same set of data as we did in this video. However, in that video, we were using a natural cubic spline, whereas in this video, I wanted to use a rather extreme example of a clamped cubic spline to show you how they vary visually. As you can see in the clamped cubic spline example, since we set the first derivatives at the beginning and end rather steep at 4, the polynomial functions need to contort themselves to achieve the smoothness and continuity throughout the length of the interpolating polynomial. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how we go about solving a clamped cubic spline interpolation problem. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.